Yeah, like, dress me up, babe. Like, yeah.
Hey babes, welcome back to my channel and thank you guys for joining me today. If you haven't, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and make sure you guys like and comment. Today we're gonna be talking all things bags. So basically I'm gonna be going through my bag collection and showing you guys what I have, telling you guys some of the funny stories behind these bags, sharing some of the bags that are on my wish list right now. Now my collection is still very much growing, but I feel like it's such a solid starter collection. I have pieces for what I feel like can fit every mood, but I have a couple voids that I do plan on filling. I'm gonna start with what I feel like are my most used and my most worn bags. Okay, starting out, this is the LV pochette bag. And I remember being in the store looking at this bag, and I loved it, but it was another bag that I saw the same day that I really wanted a lot more than this one. So I didn't end up getting it. And then like a couple weeks later for Christmas, my husband had got it for me anyway. This bag is my most worn bag ever. Like what I say, cost per wear has been gotten and gotten and gotten. Like literally, like I wear her out. I grab this bag almost every day. It is so functional, it's so practical, it fits so much. Even though both of the bags are actually smaller, it fits a lot of stuff. I can put cards, lip gloss, keys, AirPods, sanitizer, everything in this one. And in this one I could just put bigger things. I can fit my light, portable chargers, my sunglasses case. Like it fits so much. I love this bag. I wear it crossbody. I lengthen the strap or I will shorten the strap completely and just give like a little shoulder bag moment as well. I wear one bag separate from the other. Sometimes I take the small pochette off. Sometimes I clip the coin purse to the bottom. Like it's like six different bags in one. I did break the gold chain that came with this bag very early on, and I just haven't gotten it fixed yet. But I have another gold chain from this bag that I'll sometimes, if I want to just wear the small one with the, or either one with the gold chain, I'll just use that gold chain. But I did break the gold chain. I believe it's in here because I always say I'm gonna take it to the store and get it fixed, and I still have not. That's not it. What is this? Oh, this is it because it broke. Yeah. It basically like snapped. So I just really need to go and get that fixed at some point. You can change out the straps. There have been other straps that are available for purchase. And it's surprisingly the green goes with a lot more than you would think. I'm glad that I didn't get the pink one. This bag, I never will regret her. Like I wear it so much. Like I said, I just feel like it's super practical. We know Louis Vuitton will stand the test of time. I feel like I'm gonna have this bag for years and years and years to come.
Okay, moving on.
We're talking about most worn. She has to get a place in there because I do reach for this bag and wear her quite often. Funny story behind this bag. This, sometimes my husband will buy me things, not only that I like, but things that he wants to see me in or things that he likes. And I love that about him. I love that he does that because yeah, like dress me up, babe. Like, yeah. So one day he just came home with this bag for me and it was literally like a just because gift. And I thought she was so beautiful. This was like, this color was limited. This was like a gunmetal. I felt like he just felt like you're supposed to have a Lady Dior and came home with a Lady Dior. And not only did he come home with this limited color, beautiful Lady Dior on his own, he also got the customized strap that has our initials on there. So I love that. I was so like smitten with this bag, and it has it's like the champagne color hardware. And I actually, like I said, I wear this bag very, very often, more than I would have thought that I would in the beginning, because like I said, it's such a special color, but metallics were so in lately. Even when I got this bag, I probably got this bag about 2.5-3 years ago, and I felt like it was just such a special color because it wasn't silver. Like, I didn't like the silver one. So this was like the perfect, like it was just perfect. I love this bag. It goes with so much stuff. I feel like she's in great condition for me to have had her. It doesn't fit the, it fits a lot, but it's kind of a pain to get in and out. So I don't like to like stuff it or whatever. The only thing I'm concerned about with her, I wanna see if Dior has any recourse for what's going on with the handles. If you guys can see, it's losing a bit of its color on the handles. So I don't know. I haven't asked yet, but I'm curious to see if they offer anything with that. But love this bag. Like I said, she was just on a random day. I just got her and I love it. So those two are definitely my most top two, like worn, I feel like, on a day-to-day basis. The Dior, more when I'm going out, I grab her probably more than any other bag. The Louis, every day, literally, she's coming with me. If I have a bag and I'm not dressing up or putting on an outfit, that bag is coming. But if we are talking most worn dinner bags, I have to bring in Miss Tom Ford. This bag, I died for this bag. I don't know why I wanted this bag so bad. I had went in the Tom Ford store to get either this denim bag or either my denim Tom Ford padlock heels, and I saw this bag and it was on sale, and I don't remember the price at the time, but I know, you know, I just felt like girl math, a sale. Like, I just had to have it. And I thought it was so cute. I love the little box shape. I didn't have a bag this, well, I did have a bag this color, but it was the Gucci Marmont bag at the time. And I've sold that bag since. So, it was a different style. So it wasn't in, you know, I just thought this was such a cute little classy bag. I really do love this bag. She is like, she comes with me to dinner a lot. She does come with a gold chain strap as well. I don't have her in here right now, but she comes with a shoulder chain strap. I never really wear it with the chain strap. I always, you know, just carry it like this. And like I said, I wear her a lot to like dinner. I feel like she's just small, dainty, cute dinner bag. The one thing I will say, I feel like my Tom Ford bags, the two that I have, the hardware scratches the most, like the most easiest. I'm not sure. She is a little kind of beat up, little dents in her, a little scratch there. Not very dirty though, to be a white color. I feel like I, you know, kept her in pretty good condition, but she is a little bit beat up. But when I'm at dinner, nobody ain't seeing it. Like, but I died for this bag. I went back. And I was like, it's on sale. Like, and I grabbed it. And I was glad I was able to get her. So, but definitely like wear her mostly when I'm like going to dinner or wearing a dress up outfit. And it's in the browns, neutrals, golds. If I'm wearing gold jewelry, like, she comes in handy very often. She actually goes with a lot of stuff. My Balenciaga Hourglass bag. I've had this bag for some time now, and I remember when I got it, I was in the Balenciaga store in Miami Design District. And I love, this was when the Hourglass, you know, was having this moment, and I really did love this bag. This has actually been one of the bags that I had tried to sell recently. But the girl at Fashion File was basically letting me know, like, people not buying Balenciaga right now, at least not for what you paid for it, or, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't really gonna get my true value. So I decided to keep it. I still wear her. I just don't wear it as much as I used to. But she definitely had her moment with me. She does have like a shoulder strap, so I can wear her crossbody. So now I usually just throw her on if I'm like wearing something cute and casual and it has pink in it, or I just need a little pop of color. I just wear a crossbody. I don't really wear her when I'm dressing up anymore. And I don't even know why. I just don't reach for her as much as I used to. But she used to get worn a lot. Let's get into my YSL clutches. So, first up, this was the first designer bag that my husband ever bought for me. This was like my 27th birthday. And if you know, like around that time, that was what, 2017? Around that time, this bag was like super popular and hard to get. Like this particular one, the patent leather, all black with the black hardware. It was in the black chain, like, it was very hard to get, and I wanted this bag so bad because I had the black patent leather YSL booties, which I still have. But this bag,
the lip gloss, I've been looking for you.
This bag has been with me for a while, like I said, since 2017. I probably won't ever sell her. She always seems to deem herself purposeful. She comes in handy, you know what I'm saying? Like when I'm wearing an all black, you know, just a quick dinner. She's still a moment. Still very much a moment. Like, and I've taken great care of her. So, and then I got this YSL envelope clutch. And this one, this is the one I said I'd be taking the chain strap off and using it for the Louis bag sometimes. This bag, super cute. You can put your ID cards in here. It's like almost like a little wallet. You can fit more cards in here. I tend to use this bag the most on vacation. It's just so cute for dinner. Adds a pop of color. It's patent leather. She has some transfer stains on the back. Don't worry about that, because you won't be seeing her back. but, you know, she serves her purpose. Like, she gets warm for sure during vacation and warmer months. So yeah, both of these are of my beloved YSL clutches. Yeah, I still feel like they have a place with me. So let's stick with YSL and talk about this baby. This is the YSL Lulu bag. And this was an impulse purchase. We were actually just in the YSL store, just randomly looking at stuff. And he was acting like he wanted to buy me something. So I was like, let me see what y'all got. The guy pulled out a couple of the Lulu bags and like some bigger ones. And then we saw this one and my husband was like, that's dope. Like, you don't have nothing like that. And it's like a denim material. And it's like this cute, like purpley color. Gold hardware, and then the inside it's like a lilac leather, and it also has this lilac strap. So I wear it crossbody most of the time. I have had some instances where I just wore it kind of like this. I think that was on vacation or something, but it does I tend to reach for it when I'm wearing more of a casual look. But I love her. It fits a good amount of stuff. There's two slits here where I usually put like my card and, you know, card holder and stuff. In the front, I put like my lip glosses and things like that. So, she gets some room. This bag was definitely just like an impulse purchase. It wasn't like on my wish list or anything like that. But I felt like she was different with this denim color. So let's talk about something that was on my wish list. I I wanted this bag so bad. Remember when I said about the Louis bag when we were in the Louis Vuitton store and I tried that bag on? I wanted the Louis bag, but I had seen a bag that I wanted much more that same day. It was her. Like, and I had seen this already on the internet. And but when I seen her in person, we were in LA actually, shopping on Rodeo, and I saw this bag in person and I was like, oh, I went in the store and I was asking them, and I showed them like a picture on my phone, and I was asking them, did they have it? And she went back and she came out with it, and I was like, oh my God, I have to have this bag. Like, but my only gripe with this bag, because like when I got this bag, it was like very limited, very hard to find. They didn't have a lot. It had completely sold out after I got mine. And then I felt like they did some type of restock and everybody had the bag. Like, it was, you know, like it was not so exclusive, which, you know, I don't really care about stuff like that most of the time. But I felt like when I got it, I had got this like limited exclusive piece. But I just adore this bag. I love this bag. I think it's so different. I think it's unique. It's like hard, like it's a hard bag, but it's not as heavy as you would think it is. This was a part of the bamboo collection, so the handle on this is actual real bamboo. I love that the hardware is this silver and not gold, and usually I love gold hardware, but I feel like gold on this would have made it just a little bit like gaudy. There is a strap. So you can wear this crossbody, but it is going to be a little bit heavier. The inside, it's, you know, just mainly like an actual box, but I can fit perfume in here, wallet, phone, keys. Like, I can fit a lot in this bag. It does come with keys where you can actually lock this bag. You know, I never really do, but you could. I love this bag. Fun fact about this bag, after maybe wearing the bag a couple of times, I lost the strap, and it was in my, I ended up finding it literally like 2 years later. So for like 2 years, I could not even wear the bag crossbody, which hindered me from wearing it a lot, because it's just not always a bag that you're gonna go for when you're super dressed up. It has to be the right look. So the crossbody gives it, you know, gives me some versatility there. And it, I almost like didn't wear the bag very much for years, but I didn't care, because to me, this is a collector's item. I probably will never sell this bag. I'm sure it'll be in my collection for years and years. I really, really love this bag. This is definitely probably one of my top favorite bags. Not my most worn bag, but literally like one of my favorite bags in my collection. So now that I've told you about my favorite bag, let's get into my not so favorite bag. And it is the denim Tom Ford. I wanted this bag so bad, y'all. That's just so crazy. I wanted this bag really bad. They had two sizes. This was the large size, and they also had a small size, but I felt like the small size was too small. And at the time, I thought that I was trying to get like some bigger bags. I had just got the denim heels, so I wanted the denim bag to match. And I think the bag is beautiful, but I don't ever reach for it. I probably have worn this bag less than 5 times, and I've had it quite some time. A couple reasons why on that, right? So the bag itself is pretty heavy. It, as big as it is, it really doesn't fit a lot. It's not very like flexible. The, you know, it's hard, and the opening is very slim, so it doesn't really fit that much stuff. The way like I would wear it, I feel like, you know, would be like more like jean casual stuff, but then it always throws me off with the black on the handles. Like, every time I'm putting my outfit together and I'm wearing something, it's like denim, and then I'll have on like a white shirt or something, and it's like, these straps don't go, or this chain makes it too dressy or something. Like, I don't know. It never like completes the look for me. So I never end up wearing it, and it's really kind of too big for dinner. So it would need to be like somewhere to the club or something. And I don't know. And like I told y'all before, both of my Tom Ford bags, the hardware scratched very, very easily. And I have only worn this bag a handful of times, but the hardware is like really, really scratched. But like I literally, it has a pocket on the back. I've had this bag up on Poshmark for months now. I can't even like sell the bag. Like I can't get rid of this bag. I did try to sell it with Fashion File, and they lowballed me so bad. So I was like, no, I'm gonna try my own luck. So I don't know. I love the bag, but I just never reach for it. It doesn't fit for me. So she just sits. But yeah. Oh, Chanel. This was my first Chanel bag. I got her for my 30th birthday. She has champagne gold hardware, and she is the caviar leather. This is the small mini flap. This is the small classic flap. I love this bag, obviously. Classic Chanel will always be that girl. It was only fitting that I got pink. I love this color. Does the bag fit a lot? I don't know. I won't say that it fits a lot, but I also don't try to overstuff this bag because, you know, I don't want any like creasing or any damage to the bag. So I really travel light when I wear her, and I keep her stuffed when I'm not wearing her. Look, what else can I say? I love her. It's been 3 years already with her, and she definitely has held up nicely. I try to take good care of my things, because especially things like these, when you know you may want to sell them one day, so, or you may want to pass them off to your little girl. Another favorite in my collection, Miss Goyard. I love this bag. I love this bag. The Goyard Saigon bag. I got this bag for Christmas as well. I remember when I opened it, he was like, if you want to take it back and get the orange, we can get the orange, but I got this color. I like this color. And I was like, I like this color too. And he just knew like blue isn't really a color that I wear a lot, but I wear this bag so often when I'm wearing like an outfit with jeans, or if I have on like a neutral outfit and I just want to throw in like some color, I grab this bag often. She does have a crossbody strap. That's not in here. But she has like the yellow interior. Goyard is very big on like craftsmanship and detail, and I love that. I love the light wooden hardware. I love how it opens. It's not a clasp. But she gets her wear, but nothing too crazy. I keep her sitting pretty. You know, I don't bring her out too often, but I do bring her out. But I love this bag. I feel like it's very durable. I love the structures and, you know, how Goyard really plays with that structure and craftsmanship. This bag, this is not a designer bag, obviously, but it is a Black-owned brand and a customized bag. The brand is called Mono Twins, and they do all kinds of monogram customized bags. And this one was gifted to me for my bridal shower, during my engagement. And as you can see, it says wifey. It's super, super cute. It does have a strap as well. It's like a pink satin on the inside. Super cute. So I put her up here, obviously, because she's pretty. Like, and I just thought it was cute for my display. But I love this bag. The quality is so good. I haven't lost a bead yet. And I just think it's so beautiful and pretty. So now we can talk about our newest bags. This is one of the newest bags in my collection. This is the Loewe puzzle bag. And this is the newer model of the Loewe puzzle bag. If you guys know, there was an older version that is considered the OG, the original, the classic. But I did get the newer version, which I love just as much. What I was most drawn to about this bag is the color. It's very much like its name, sand. Like, it's not your typical like nude or like tan. It's very much sand. I love this bag. I have actually not even worn her yet, and I've had her about 2 months now, just about going on 2 months actually, and I just haven't had the moment to wear her yet. She has a little zip pocket on the back. This bag, even though this is the small size, I feel like she can fit a lot. She does have a crossbody strap. She's stuffed right now, but you can wear her crossbody or just by the little top handle. The lady in the store was telling me like, oh, you know something cool about this bag? Like, you can take it out and flatten it and completely like squish it and to travel with it, and it'll go flat. And I was like, girl, I'm not squishing up my bag like that. And I was like, isn't that gonna like crease the leather a bit? And she was like, yeah, just a little bit, but you know, that's kind of like the character of the bag. I'm like, girl, please, I'm not squishing my bag up like flat like that. Like, she will be in a dust bag politely sitting somewhere that she will not be getting smushed, or she will be worn when I travel. Like, I understand that the puzzle bags can do that, but mine won't be doing that. But yes, love, 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 love this bag. I've had her about 2 months now, and I cannot wait to wear her. And last but not least, the very newest addition to my collection, my newest Chanel bag. This is the mini flap top handle. I just got this bag last week for my birthday. I was in need of a black bag. I have been saying that I need a black bag, I need a black bag. So yes, my husband delivered with this baby. This is so cute. I feel like this particular style and size is having its moment right now. I'm really, really obsessed. It's the lambskin. So I'm also nervous about having a lambskin bag because they are very easy to like scratch, and like, I don't want nothing like scratching my bags. I really try, like, if you see, I even still have the sticker on here. I'm very particular about my hardware. Like, I keep my stickers on for as long as I can until they literally like peel it and look at trifling. So yeah, say what you want, but I try to keep my hardware together. She has her chain strap. If I had my way, the strap would be removable, but it's not. But I'll show you guys like where it sits crossbody. It's kind of like where it sits on the body. Super, super cute. And even if I don't want to wear crossbody, I'm just fine with letting the strap hang like that. So yes, like, she's so cute and so dainty. I feel like he did great with this one. So guys, I hope you guys have enjoyed this. Let me know in the comments what you think. Let me know if you guys want any additional details. This is my designer bag collection. And like I said, I'm very much still growing my collection. I do have a wish list I'm gonna include next, some bags that I have been eyeing or some things that I wanna put on my wish list coming soon. So stay tuned and stick around for that. These are just my designer bags. I have other bags like Zara and different types of everyday bags that I also very much love. If you guys want to see some of those, just let me know. I'm fine with showing some of those as well. I do try to buy pieces that I really like. When it comes to buying bags, I don't go so much with the trends, but things that I feel like are timeless or things that I feel like would really add to my collection and get worn, because I wear my pieces as much as I can. So I do put some thought into it when I am buying bags or when I am hinting at the bags that I want. Certain designers, you know, you'll see me repeat buying. And there are some designers that I have my eye on that I have not been able to score anything yet, such as Bottega is the one. I still do not have a Bottega bag in my collection, and I almost pulled the trigger on a couple Jodies like multiple times, but I didn't. So that is one designer I know for sure that's like on my hit list. I still would like another Loewe bag. It's the hammock bag, I think it is. I really do like that one. There was a white one in the store when I got the puzzle bag, and I was so drawn to that white bag. And it's like, I don't even necessarily, I'm not even a white bag person, but that looked so good in white. Obviously I haven't been playing the Hermes game, so I don't ever know if I'll get one of those. But even like their entry level bags, I do love the Evelyn, I love the Picotin. Between Kelly and Birkin, I would love a Kelly. I love her over the Birkin, but I do think the Birkin is a classic timeless bag, and I think she is actually a great bag for travel. You guys will be able to stick around and see as my collection continues to grow. I've gotten rid of a couple bags this past year. I mentioned that Gucci Marmont bag. I did get rid of that. Still working on this Tom Ford bag, and I will make some decisions probably soon on the Balenciaga Hourglass. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please leave a comment. Please hit the like button. And please, please, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys for all your support. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.